Hello everyone, welcome to this demonstration on autoscaling and zero downtime updates for API Manager in Kubernetes. In the previous demonstration, we looked at how to deploy WSO2 API Manager in Kubernetes. This will be the outline for the demo. First, we're going to look at how to autoscale WSO2 API Manager based on the production load. For that, we're going to use horizontal pod autoscaler. Second, we're going to see how to apply rolling updates on WSO2 API Manager with zero downtime. As the first step, we have to install all the prerequisites. I have already installed the prerequisites. In order to use the WSO2 Kubernetes resources, you need to have an active subscription. If not, you can sign up for WSO2 free trial subscription. First part of the demo will be autoscaling WSO2 API Manager based on the production load. How does HPA work? In Kubernetes, there is an inbuilt HPA controller. It will monitor all the HPA objects and check continuously our predefined metrics and target CPU utilization. If the target exceeds, it will increase the number of replica set to maintain an average CPU utilization across all the pods. Default, we have only one API Manager pod. After we exceed our target, it will scale another pod. Let's start the demo. Let's create a horizontal pod autoscaler that maintains between 1 to 2 replica set. Copy paste the command. For the demo purposes, I'm going to use 5% as target CPU utilization. Maximum pod will be 2 pods, and then minimum pods will be 1 pod. Okay. Let's check the status of the HPA. I'm using Hello Client script to send 70 requests per minute to achieve the CPU load. Let's check the status of the HPA again. I'm gonna add another script to achieve our CPU load. As you can see, the target has been exceeded. Let's check the status of the pod. As you can see, one pod is containerizing. Let's check the replica set. Before, we had only one pod, now we have 2 pods, which is containerizing still. Even before, we have only one replica set. Now we have 2 replica sets. And only one pod is in the ready state. Let's check the status of the script. As you can see, there's no any failures. We can successfully invoke an API. the scale pod and the other pod is in the running state. That's it on autoscaling. Let's move on to the second part of the demo. Second part of the demo will be applying rolling updates on WSO2 API Manager with zero downtime. Let's start the demo. Go back to the terminal. Let's describe that part. In this part of the demo, I'm gonna show how to update API Manager with zero downtime. Already we have two pods. Image tag will be 2.60. Already we have an created image called WSO2 AM latest with latest update. This is the YAML we used earlier. As you can see, the image tag will be 2.60. And this is the YAML we're gonna use to update with the latest image tag. And the type will be rolling update. That's the only difference in this YAML. Let's redeploy our deployment. Okay, let's check the status of the pod. As you can see, one pod is terminating and another pod is containerizing. Let's check the replica set. This is the old version replica set, and this is the replica set with the latest version. Slowly it deletes the pods of the old replica set and creates pods on the new replica set. As you can see, we have one pod running in 2.60 and another pod running in latest. At least there will be one pod running. Even the client script is running without any failures. While it's updating, still, we can invoke an API. There are two pods now. Let's check the replica set. Zero pods on the old replica set and two pods on the new replica set. As you can see, this pod is on running state. Let's describe that pod. Two pods are in running state. Now let's go and check the script. As you can see, there's no any failures, no downtime, we can successfully invoke an API. The old pod won't terminate until the updated pod is in the ready state. This concludes the demonstration on applying rolling updates on WSO2 API Manager with zero downtime. Thank you.